Hey again, guys. Sportsmania Card back here. I am going to cover part two of my COMC. Check out my card mail day that I received on Monday. I previously posted part one earlier. It had some various players, Astros, Madden Lee, a couple football cards, Biggio, a few vintage. Just a hodgepodge. This part two is strictly going to be my Jeff Bagwell pickups. I haven't counted how many I got, but there's the stack right there. So, I don't know, 80 to 100 cards. The total order was 161. So, hey, we'll start out with this 1998 Donruss collections. It has the little collections embossing here on the side. Don't know if you can see it. I'm not sure the story behind these, but they did it across a run of different products in 98 Donruss. You got the Leaf Anniversary Curtain Call here. And then there's the this one here is another one of the collections. It says right here. This was from the Donruss Elite brand. There's the back of the first one. Kind of a reprint of his rookie card from 91 Leaf. Another collections, another Donruss Elite. And one more. This is the Donruss Days. I'm familiar with Donruss Days. They were a set sent to shop owners, I guess, to like promote the 98 Donruss set. This one is a Donruss Days limited edition. So I couldn't find a whole bunch of information about this on Baseball Cardpedia. I'm sure I have in the past, but I couldn't pull it up today. But anyway, just another neat parallel with Bagwell. This is from Pacific Aurora. 1998 Aurora Hardball Cell Fusions. These were 1 in 73 packs. It is kind of a die cut. It is a die cut card. You can see it right there. It's like the baseball shape. So pretty neat little die cut there. Had a Gold Stars Bagwell from Score. This is from 96 or 97 Stadium Club Firebrand. It's also a die cut. It's got the Firebrand kind of cut out there. You can see it shadowing off my hand. Kind of has a wood feel to it. There's a nice silver prism. You can see that shine back there. Real, real nice. I have a whole bunch of different versions of these. Gold, pebbles, pulsars. There's tons of them. I was going to do the rainbow, but just too many and gets kind of pricey. This is a Pacific Crown Royal, Diamond Knights, I believe. This one bad thing about COMC, it is kind of hard when you have an order currently you're working on their site, you're searching cards, scrolling through cards, you pick a card out, you put it in your cart, and then you come across it again, you're like, did I already put that in my cart? And it's just kind of hard to go back and forth looking in your cart. But I've done this numerous times, but you know what, these are amazing cards. This is a Forte from 1999 Upper Deck. But I mean, these cards, look at that. That is just gorgeous. Just dances. Nice rainbow. Isn't that beautiful? So yeah, I picked up two of them. I'm very organized with the cards I already have. I have all my Bagwells in a big box, three row, and have it broken down by years and then product. So I very rarely pick up a dupe if I already have it. But like I said, one of them was in my checkout, my cards cart. Saw it again, purchased it again. But I did that actually a few times in these cards I'll be showcasing today. Speaking of showcase, here's a showcase from Flair Showcase 1998, the Showstopper. These cards are just also awesome and beautiful. They kind of look like the Gold Label brand. And here's another one. This one's from 99. Oop. So you got the 98 back there, you got the 99 right here. Just the beautiful shine going on. Nice stuff. This is from Leaf Limited. It's called Lumberjacks. It also has the wood feel, hence Lumberjacks. It is serial numbered to 5000. This is from 1996. Really neat card. We all love these gold medallions. Fleur Ultra Gold Medallion from 99. It's a cool card. And here's a. No, this is not a gold medallion. This is the Hot Numbers 95 Flair. Here is another one I boneheadedly picked up two of. But it's another one to pick up two of that's nice, so it's blinding. SPX 1996. So yeah, got two of those by accident, but no problemo. Bagwell says no problem. Right, I had seen guys talking about these a lot. The Ringleaders from Stadium Club 1995. They talked about how much they shined and one of the most beautiful insert sets I've ever seen. So I picked it up and I'm not too impressed. I mean, it has some nice shine to it. It's got a lot going on. It's real busy. You got the eagle in the background, you got the stadium in the background, the ring up here. I mean, it's a nice card. They're pretty, but I was expecting more. I mean, it's got a lot going on. There's a lot of angles you can do it, and just different things pop. So this is the base version, and then I also picked up the Members' Choice or Members Only. These were in factory set form. It's got the little emblem right here. The 4,000 factory sets made. So, no emblem on this one, the members only on that one. So, they're not bad. It's just a Star Quest single from Collector's Choice. Nothing too special there, but I surprisingly didn't have it, so I do now. Fleer Tradition Tales of the Tape. Got a little bit of ribbon right here going with some shine. Sparkle. We got a Diamond Kings 2004. I believe it's just a base card, but nice look. Got a little bit of textured feel to it. Talked about this in a previous video. The 2001 Topps Heritage are really, really popular to set collectors. Just a real nice artwork, if you want to call it that. A lot of these superstars go for several dollars. Even just the base cards, Hall of Famers. But I was able to pick up the Bagwell and the Biggio for uber cheap. The refractor versions of these and the chrome version of these are pretty pricey. All right, we got a today's spotlight from 95 Flair. Got a die cut action going on with this guy too. This is from 93 Upper Deck. Nice hologram going on. These are really nice. I think I picked up a Mattingly in my previous video and showed it off. This is from Pacific Crown Royal. This is Pillars of the Game. Pillars of the Game, not Pillows of the Game. Ticketmasters from Leaf Rookies and Stars. Got Bagwell on the front, Mr. Biggio on the back, and these are numbered to 2,500. This is not just your everyday 91 Studio. This is the preview card. It says right here in the corner. And it'll say it up on the back. Preview card 16 to 22. So these were sent out to dealers in preparation for the 92, I said 91, I'm sorry, 92 Studio release. All right, we got a 95 Pinnacle, white hot. Had the red hot for quite a while and just was able to pick up the white hot. These are nice Dufex technology going on here. Even on the back, it's got a little bit. So, nice card there. Forgot the story about this card. This is a Topps Finest blank back. What I do is I go through Baseball Cardpedia. I start with a year, for example, 1998, and then I pull up every single brand from 98, and I click on the link. It's alphabetical, and I'll start out with the first set. I go through each and every set, read about the sets, look at, they'll talk about preview cards, they'll talk about samples. They talk about parallels, variations. It breaks down the insert sets by pack odds. It's just a very, very amazing website. So, upon my research, I came across this, but I can't even tell you now what year it is or anything about it. But some kind of Topps Finest card, blank back. These are from 2019 Allen and Ginter. You got the base card on the right, and you got the black X on the back, on the left. Say 2001 Topps, but it is the home team advantage. These were released in a factory set only. Don't recall how many were made. This is from Holographics. Night. Sorry, I don't can't tell every single year. 99 Holographics, Upper Deck. Nice card with a lot of swirly swirls going on in the back. There's a UD Choice preview. Another preview card. Those are just fun to pick up. They're not super rare, but it's kind of nice to pick up cards that weren't released to the general population or in pack form. These were sent to dealers and given to sales reps. So they're not expensive, but they're just different and something to add to your collection. That's what we're here for, to collect. 2004 Donruss Fantasy Team. This one has a lot of nice shine to it. It is numbered to 4,000. Make sure I got that year right. Yes, I was way off. This was 1998. Don't know why I said 2004. But yeah, nice shine. This one I was really in awe of. It is the sample card, but the certified gold team from Pinnacle Certified, 1997. I don't know if I guess I don't have the base version of this, but these are amazing. The shine on these, the sparkle. I mean, I got my camera flashlight on and it's blinding me. So, need to check and see if I have this base card. Pretty sure I don't, but I need to pick up this gold. I guess the golds aren't base cards. I guess they're a parallel or. But yeah, very nice. I'm gonna definitely look into that card. Put it to the side. And an RBI Kings from FLIR Ultra. Sorry for the pause there. My camera, for a second, I didn't think it was recording. 95 FLIR Ultra RBI Kings. This is from SP Authentic 19. Oh, 2000. This is a Superstar, SP Superstars. It is serial numbered to 2500 over here on the left-hand side. Number 16 of 2500. Nice design. That's not a overly exciting card, but I like the background. It's nice. This is from Upper Deck Vintage, Night Gamers. I just like this card because of the black borders, the black outline design, just nice looking card. That's from 2002. Platinum Edition 1996 Metal Universe. These were, I think, one per pack, so not super hard to pull. I never pulled any back in the day. I wasn't aware of them till probably 2 or 3 years ago. And so they're pretty cool. This card is the View to a Thrill from Upper Deck 1999. Was surprised I didn't have this card. It's not a super crazy insert. I do have the Biggio version, so maybe I never picked up the Bagwell, thinking I had the Bagwell, but it was the Biggio. Got them both now. Here's another one that I goofed up and got two, but again, it's another one to it's nice to have two of. Special Effects from SP 1997. So yeah, I got the real nice hologram right there in the middle. Two Bagwell stances. Well, two Bagwell swings. Nice picture of shades on the back. Yeah, a lot going on with this card. You know what? This is actually, these aren't the same. These, yeah, maybe they are. Yeah, they are. Okay. I saw the hologram in the background here, but it's on both of them. 95 FLIR Team Leaders. Whoa. You got Bagwell on the front. Drabek on the back. These are pretty neat. I hadn't seen these before, but you got some nice gold sparkle going on these cards as well. These two are nothing spectacular. This is just the base card. These are from 99 Ultimate Victory. Up, yeah, that one's 99 Victory. Just a base card. Then you got the ultimate victory. And then I have the, I don't know what it is. It's serial number to 100. Real nice looking card. So I picked these up kind of for the rainbow effect. Talked about this in the previous video. This is from Grand Old Gamers, 2005 National Pastime from Fleer. I just love, like I said, love when the card has the American flag in the background. So really neat insert set. This is a 98 Pinnacle Museum. We all know and love the museums, kind of like the artist proofs. This is just a postcard, 2002 Topps Post. So, didn't have that. There's a base card from Fleer Brilliance. If you can pick up the colored ones, the golds, the reds, the blues, those are amazing. This one's just a base card, silver, but kind of a thicker card. Real nice. This is from 2004 Leaf Second Edition Gamers. Another card I wasn't familiar with. There's a nice die cut from Pacific Crown. 99, it looks like. Upper Deck Textbook Excellence. Another one I thought I had, but I think it was the Biggio that I had, not the Bagwell. This is 2000 Pacific. Just a base card right there. I think it's called like the portrait variation. I think there's another variation, maybe fielding or batting or something. Just a nice portrait shot of Bagwell there. And then you got the red or ruby version as well. I think they have several versions of this. Maybe gold, blue, etc. I'm not sure, but picked up these two. Fleer Award winner from 94, it looks like. 95. This is 1992 Upper Deck. You may be saying, eh, just a base card. No. You flip it over, and if you look at the hologram up here, it's gold. Not sure if you can tell that on camera, probably not. But the gold holograms were factory sets only. The pack ones, pack issued cards had the silver hologram. So, just like I said, adding to that Bagwell collection and trying to pick up oddball variations and factory set cards, just trying to get it all. We got a Bagwell Pacific collection here. This is, I'm not real sure what this is, 97 Pacific collection. It's a nice Bagwell with all the Pacific craziness going on. Prominent Powers from Upper Deck, Finite. This is 329 out of 499, or Finite. Thunder Limited Access. This is from Circa, actually. Circa 1998 Circa Limited Access. Got some die cut going on the sides. But watch this. Card unfolds. So, yeah, look at that. He can sit down. So, yeah, just something a little different there. This card, I saw someone showing it off. Probably Essential Credentials, these Matrix cards. These are 1997 Stadium Club Matrix. And I've seen some that really have some amazing stuff going on. This one doesn't seem to have as much. I mean, it's got some nice shots going on. Look at that. It's a beautiful card. I guess just some of the designs on some of the other ones have some swirlies going on in the card. But I mean, it's still very nice. These are called the Matrix. See, no matter which way you turn it, you get some kind of different thing going on. That's the fun thing about watching everyone's videos. You can see something they post and like, oh, I don't have that in my guy. You gotta go pick it up. I talked about this in my previous video too. These are from Donruss called XVP 1.0, 1997. A very low-end set. But I haven't seen a lot of these out there, and I think a lot of it is people just threw them away, didn't open them, threw them in the attic, and they're still there. And so just kind of a different base card there I hadn't seen before. This is Banner Season from 97 Leaf, I believe. Yeah. These are serial numbered. These are hard to get out. Serial number to 2500. But they have a canvas feel to them. So you can see the die cut to So yeah, the family's out of the house today. Wife and kid went out just to run some errands. The wife's going to be out of town for 2 or 3 days with my daughter on a college tour. So she's spending some time with the 3-year-old. The daughter is at band competition. My son's home for the weekend from college, but he's working. So had 3 or 4 hours to myself today. Thought I'd mess with cards. This is the Knothole Gang from 97 Leaf. Knothole Gang, numbered to 5000. Another one from 97 Leaf called Dress for Success. Serial number to 3500. And these have like a nylon feel to them. Some felt action going on the Astros logo there. No, I'm not playing with the Bagwells, but. Alright, we got an encore from something upper deck. 99 upper deck. Nice purple shine to this guy. This is Pacific Invincible. Looks like 98 or 99. 98. There's a Diamond King from 2005. I think this is the purple version or ruby version or something red. There's a whole bunch of different parallels of these. We got Upper Deck Tape Measure Titans. This one's numbered to 2667. Kind of a different serial numbering system here. It's like stamped. This one's stamped 1706. So each card was individually stamped. Got a special effects gold from SP. That's a lot of beautiful shine there. The hologram, you got the gold going on, all the rainbow effects. This is from 2000 Upper Deck Black Diamond. This is the Diamond Nation. I mentioned earlier I saw Dub Mentality open up a box of this on his channel, and so I had to grab my guys. So there's the Bagwell Domination, and then also the gold right here, serial numbered 447 of 1,000. These are real nice. This is from Triple Crown 2001 Glamour Boys. Look at that beautiful shine. You got Bernie Williams, Bagwell, and Scott Rolen. Got a Hall of Famer in the middle. Bernie and Scott, not quite great players, but I don't think they'll get into the hall. Just nice card. I usually don't like cards with multiple players on them. But this one is just so pretty. I had to get it. This is a Fleer Tradition 1999. Again, it looks just like a base card. But this is the Millennial Edition. You can see the little stamp here in the corner. These were only 5,000 factory sets were printed, and Fleer sold all of them to the Shop at Home Network. So, kind of a tough card to get, not factory, not package insert, not a wide release, just only 5,000 factory sets sold to Shop at Home. So somebody broke open the set and I got it. I got the Bagwell. There's another Upper Deck Finite. This one's serial numbered to 1999. 92 Donruss long ball leaders. Another Team Timber. These have the wood grain. Well, this one doesn't. There's another Team Timber that has the wood grain feel to it. This one's from 97 tops. Grip it and rip it. Or get a grip. I'm sorry, get a grip. You got Bagwell on the front. Got Pat Hentgen on the back. These were serial numbered to 3,500. You can see down here. Couple of Bagwell Diamond Kings. We got 2003, 2002 on the left, and on the right is 02. Nice framed cards. They kind of got a frame going around the outside of them. We're almost done, guys. Sorry about the lengthy video today. We all love a gold label. Look at the shine. Look at the shine. This is a Class 2. God, it's so gorgeous. I will never get tired of 90s cards. All right, I got three press proofs here. Silver press proofs. This one is numbered, or not numbered, but it is one of 1500, so print run of 1500, not serial numbered as we're used to, but it is a print run of 1500. This is from 98 Donruss. There's another one, the Hit List, and this one is also one of 1500. And another one here, Spirit of the Game, silver press proof. Numbered to 1500. So, kind of a nice little run there. Three press proofs, all from 98 Donruss, silver. The last card, Titanic Taters. 1996 score. This card is beautiful. Got a lot of shine, got an explosion going on there. Some stadium in the background. Shout out to Mr. Titanic Taters. He's got a channel here on YouTube. Very popular guy. Eric Leet, I believe. He's in the fa our Facebook group. 1990s to 2004. Him and Nate are buddies, and they do Baseball Card Junkies TV. So they don't need any shout outs. They're pretty much one of the most popular guys on YouTube for the 90s groups and We all know him here from the 90s through 04 Facebook group. So here we go, Titanic Taters for the win, as Nate would say. So that's it, guys. I know it was a lengthy video today, but I had to show off all this Bagwell goodie for my Monday check out my card mail day. Have a rest of your Saturday. Be great. My Astros will be coming on in about 4 or 5 hours. Hoping to go up 2-0 of those Rays. We got the Yankees and Twins coming up at 4 o'clock. So hope y'all enjoy the games. Later, guys, and be good to each other.